What's going on, guys? Tech Examine back with another video. And today I want to do something a little bit different. I want to talk about LUTs. They're short for lookup tables. And to me, they're basically just a specific color grading that you can put over your footage. Now, if you're looking to dress up any kind of work that you're doing, any kind of footage, any kind of project, this will help you get that right look. And if you want some dramatic cold area and it's not where you're at and you want to make it look like that, you can do like one that, you know, pumps up the blues and the whites and it makes it a really cold area, or you can get warmer or darker. If you've seen any kind of movie and you think to yourself, there is no way life looks like that, well, that's color grading, and most likely it's someone that it's very, very good at it. And some use LUTs, and what that LUT does, it gives you a starting point. It lets you get a feeling. For example, me in here in the office, I like to have it look as natural and normal as possible. But if you want to spice it up a little bit, there you go. Now, one of these LUTs that I'm using right now is from my buddy Jay Lippman. And he did a pack for 2019, and I actually want to show you that video real quick before we get into how you can get these and how to put them on your computer for Final Cut Pro 10, which is what I'm going to show you. How awesome did that look? I mean, the dude did such a good job, and I like the LUTs that he actually did for 2019, and it gets you started. If you don't like the way it's looking, you can bring it back a little bit, you can change it, and what I want to show you today is how to get them on the Final Cut Pro 10, something that Jay doesn't necessarily have because he uses DaVinci and Premiere Pro. He knows how to get them on there, and you can follow his videos, and I'll put his channel down there as well, and you can go check him out. But I want to show you guys how to get them on Final Cut Pro 10 because it is a little bit tricky, and I want to make sure that if you're going to go buy these, you can use them and not think, man, like, what did I buy? What's the point? I can't even figure this out. That's what we're going to do. All right, so you've downloaded some LUTs. You know, as much as I would love you to buy Jay's LUTs, that would be cool. However, this will work with any LUT that you find, buy for free, whatever. For Final Cut Pro 10, you need to actually download what I'm showing you right here, the Pixel Film Studios, a LUT loader. And this is free software, and I will put the link down in the description. Once you download that, that will put it in your effects bin under video, of course, and it is under Pixel Film Studios. And what you're going to do is you're going to take this, drag it in to your footage, and drop it on there. Now, I've already done that. So when you go to your footage, you're actually going to see the Final Cut Pro 10 LUT loader. And this will allow you to come in here and choose an external LUT. So it opened up right to Jay's folder, and you can pick any one that you want. Now, I've already added the file to this because I was showing you guys the different looks that you can get. But I went ahead and dropped the Pixel Film Studio already in here. And what I can do is go in here back into the folder. So let's go ahead and change this to winter and add that in there. And we'll go ahead and set up the effect. Get rid of my color grading that's already on there. So there you go. Boom. Now, obviously, that isn't something that we're going to want. Of course, if you don't like what you're looking at there, you can immediately turn it off and see where you started and where you went. But of course, that's not the one I would pick. You know, picking the home right there. And that would let me set that up, and then I can go to my starting point. Now, the LUT loader itself does a very good job, in my opinion, of letting you mix everything up and changing it to the way that you want it, even if you want to back off the entire look and just do like a 40 to 50%, you can do that to take it completely away from what you're trying to do if you don't want to go that harsh. And it lets you mess with saturation, brightness, gamma, contrast, pivot, as you can see there. And then individually, the highlights, the midtones, and the shadows, and then color mix. So this is very cool to be able to go in and adjust these by the way that you want. Whites into the dark colors, and you know, whites into the actual different colors. So that's super easy. Anyone can do it. Again, like I said, the software is free. Links in the description for everything. I want to thank Jay for hooking me up with the footage that he has. I went and bought the stuff personally myself because I think it's worth it. So let's just put it out there right now. If you're interested in picking it up, again, link in the description. It is my affiliate link, so you're helping me out as well, like I just said. And if you guys enjoyed this video, please feel free to give it a thumbs up. If you're stopping by for the first time, hit that subscribe button. Take it easy. Have a good day.